Today, I'm going to continue the series on Fibonacci heaps and discuss the decrease key method. As you know from previous videos, a Fibonacci heap implements a mergeable heap. This video will focus on decrease key. Before we look at examples, I want to review the concept of marked, which I briefly discussed in the first video. Marked is a Boolean that indicates whether the node has lost a child since the last time it was made the child of another node. That's a mouthful, I know, but this property helps us keep desired time bounds for our Fibonacci heap methods by keeping track of some of the node's history. If a node's marked value is true, I'll color it yellow. Let's start with the code, then we'll take a look at a few examples. The decrease key function takes two parameters. X, which is a pointer to the node whose key we want to decrease, and K, which is the new key value. We first check if the new key value is greater than the current key value. If it is, we exit the function. Next, we update X's key and set it to K. We store a pointer to X's parent called Y. We then check to see if we've broken our min heap properties. Remember that a key of a parent must be less than or equal to the key of the child. In other words, nodes get larger as you go down. This is the statement to check that, and if it's true, we call cut and cascading cut, which I'll discuss in detail in a bit. Finally, we check if X's new key value is less than the current min, in which case we update the min pointer. Let's put this code to action on the following Fibonacci heap. Note that this is the same heap from the CLRS book, my main source. The book is linked in the description. I'll clear some real estate to make room for the code. We're going to decrease the key of node 46 to 15. I'll color node 46 blue. This node is X in our code. To start, we immediately skip the first if condition, as 15 is less than 46. We set X's key to the new value 15. We set a pointer to X's parent, 24, and call it Y. I'll color Y green. We then check to see if our min heap property is broken. Obviously it is, as 15 is less than 24. We call the cut function, passing in X and Y. Let's take a look at the code for cut. Its job is to simply cut the link between X and Y by moving X into the root list. It first removes X from Y's child list and decrements Y's degree by 1. It then merges X with the root list and sets its parent to none and mark to false. Back to our example, we execute the cut function. We move 15 to the end of the root list, which is how we coded the merge with root list function. Next, we call the cascading cut function. Let's take a closer look. This method performs a cascading cut of X's parent Y and helps us obtain certain time bounds. In other words, the cut cascades all the way to the root list. We start by grabbing a pointer to Y's parent called Z. If Z is not none, we check the mark on Y, and if it's false, we set it to true. If Y is marked, we call cut, this time with Y and Z, and then execute cascading cut again with Z. You can see the recursive nature of cascading cut. These two lines are our termination points. When Z is none, we've reached the root list. We also stop when we reach an unmarked node. Back to our example, I'm going to swap out the decrease key code with cascading cut. We set our pointer to Y's parent, which I'll color purple. Z is not none, but you can see Y is unmarked. We mark it, coloring it yellow, and return. Lastly, we check if X is less than min. Notice we only need to compare these two since X is the only key whose value changed. 15 is not less than 7, so we're finished. Let's do one more example, this time a little more complex, as there will be multiple cascading cuts. Let's decrease node 35 to 5. I'll color 35 blue and change its value to 5. We set Y to X's parent. I'll use a green circle to indicate Y, since it's yellow because it's marked. We can see that our min heap property is broken, so we cut 5, moving it to the end of the root list. This is the same heap, just shifted over. We now call cascading cut on Y. First, we set Z, which will indicate by a purple circle. We can see that Z is not none, and also that Y is marked, so we cut Y, again moving it to the end of the root list. We call cascading cut again, this time with node 24. We store a pointer to his parent, which I'll color green. Again, the parent is not none and the node is marked, so we cut it and move it to the end of the root list. Again, we call cascading cut. This time, Z is node 7, the node that's colored green. We can immediately see that Z has no parent, so we've reached the end of our recursion. Returning to the decrease key function, the final step is to compare X with the min. This time, we do need to update the min pointer. Here is the result of our Fibonacci heap after decreasing two keys. The code with these exact examples are linked in the description below. I'm not going to prove runtime in this video, but as we learned in the first video, decrease key has an amortized cost of big O of 1. Thank you for watching. I hope this video helps you on your computer science journey. Please like and subscribe.